Yo, what is up, you guys? I'm DeAndre.
I'm Javante.
And this is Dre and Jay, here today to give you guys another trailer reaction. This one is to Disney's live-action Pinocchio.
I'm telling you, that song's from When You Wish Upon a Star. I think that's a Pinocchio song, bro.
Is it?
I think so. We're going to see.
Pinocchio is actually a Disney movie where I think I've only watched it maybe once or twice.
I've never seen Pinocchio.
It's not really.
I just know that he wants to be a boy. His nose grows when he lies. That's all I know.
Huh.
I've never seen Pinocchio, the cartoon, the animated.
So you just know the character, the folklore.
Yeah. I seen him in Shrek.
Oh, yeah, Shrek. He's funny. Tell him you're wearing ladies' underwear. I'm wearing, what is it? Oh, yeah, tell us you're not wearing ladies' underwear. I'm not wearing ladies' underwear.
Shoot.
Yeah. So, yeah, you know, Pinocchio, I've only seen it once or twice. It's not like most Disney movies with me. Like, Lion King, I've seen that movie over 100 times. Or, you know, Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast. Because Pinocchio, I think, is one of the oldest Disney animated movies. What, 1950, 1960s? Which is crazy. Actually, let me look that up real quick, just to fact check.
You look cool. That shit while the trailer was playing.
Oh, yeah, I couldn't.
You guys, they got them just sitting here. They come for a trailer reaction. You know, your ass over here got...
But then I'm not going to be focusing on the trailer.
I didn't say when was Pinocchio created.
1940. Yeah, 1940.
You could do that after the damn video.
Okay, nigga, goddamn. Don't criticize.
All right, that's right. All right. I'm on the tape.
All right.
Fuck.
Beauty and the Beast. The
fuck.
And legendary director Robert Zemeckis.
Oh, Tom Hanks. Goat. Going the goat's name. I knew I was tripping!
Oh, Jimmy Cricket.
I knew I wasn't tripping when I said that shit.
Design.
Now you singing it out?
Your dreams come true.
I thought that was a song. I didn't know. I remember that song as a kid. That song was. I remember that song. When You Wish.
You ain't got to sing.
I know it was a Pinocchio thing.
Yeah, this is good. Honestly, you know what? I've been a person that has always said, like, Disney, if they're going to do live action films, they should do it more based on these ones, the ones that came out in early 1940s, 1950s, like this, Aristocrats, should get a live action. I would love to see The Rescuers get a live action adaptation. But when you make movies like The Lion King, even Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, like...
I don't think it's that, though, because, like, it's about how it's done. Chip and Dale, I love Chip and Dale.
Yeah, Chip and Dale wasn't bad.
Chip and Dale's really good. But, like, I don't know. There's certain ones I just don't feel like they do a great. I don't fight. They give you what the cartoon never gave you.
I just feel like the cartoon version. I just feel like some Lion King, especially because I feel like some should age. Because remember, Lion King had the re-release in theaters. What was it, like 2005, 2006? They had the re-release in theaters. Then they had that supposed thing, which a lot of Disney films had that supposed thing going on, where they were like, "Oh, watch it for the last time before it goes in the vault."
The vault.
Yeah, the vault. Which Yeah, that shit lasted for how many years?
And that vault was classic. There used to be a lot of shit that go in that vault.
Yeah, but the shit ain't even in the vault.
It's not like streaming now. You got streaming now.
You're just streaming. And plus, I see copies sold at Walmart every day. You go to Walmart, Target, you can find Lion King on the shelves.
No. There was a time I forgot what, I think it was like 04, 03, 04. I think when the vault was coming. Well, I don't think it was for Lion King, though. I think it was, what was going in the vault?
No, I remember they were putting Lion King in the
vault. It was Lion King. But I know they did put, that vault shit was to be real, bro.
Yeah, it only lasted for how many years, and then...
Because streaming on shit came out too, though. But I will say, look, guys, I don't know much about Pinocchio. And the trailer was like, okay, this is cool. It didn't get me till they started playing my song. They probably like, with you, with... All right, oh, shit, that's a Jiminy Cricket. Oh, shit, I'm hooked. I'm in. You got me. So now I'm in. I never seen the original Pinocchio. For me, this is going to be a first-time experience watching this. I don't think I want to go back and watch the original now. Now I might just watch this and know about this one.
Yeah.
This is cool, though. It looks good. I'm excited to watch it, man. You know, honestly, Chip and Dale really revived when it came to Disney making live action, because Chip and Dale did a great job. Also, Chip and Dale played with both cars, like cartoon slash live action, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But still, I love Chip and Dale. Will be my top 10 of the year.
But I don't think Disney necessarily has like a live action problem. I mean, I think some films actually turned out
good.
Jungle Book was good.
Well, okay, Jungle Book was good, but also at Mowgli, at Andy Serkis was good too.
Yeah, but I still think
Disney Jungle Book was good.
Disney one was good. I thought Dumbo was good.
I don't watch Dumbo.
You never watched Dumbo?
I thought
Dumbo, but Dumbo was another movie that was made early, like what, 1950s, and got translated to live action. It felt right. So,
the bangers that they thought they had, the bangers. Jungle Book's always been good though. Even when you did the Jungle, they always done Jungle Book live action.
I think Maleficent.
Maleficent's cool, but Maleficent never had a cartoon version.
Alice in Wonderland, the first one, for sure. That was a good one.
I look at Maleficent, but her character was never created in a cartoon like of her own self. It was just her as a villain, so it was all different.
Okay, fine, take that away. But still, Alice in Wonderland was a good one.
Who's the other one you said?
Dumbo.
And what's the other one?
Hmm?
What's the other one you just said?
Jungle Book.
Jungle Book's been done multiple times as live action. We saw Jungle Book back in 05 or maybe that one in 03.
Yeah, I remember.
So yeah, Jungle Book's been done live action before, so it wasn't nothing new. It looked good. It looked amazing. The voice actors were amazing. Yeah. They had a great cast. But we've seen Jungle Book done multiple times in live action.
So in Lion King, I didn't hate the movie. You know,
Lion King, I haven't rewatched that one. I'll go back and watch that cartoon, bro.
Yeah.
They fucked up when they changed Ed. They changed a whole bunch of other shit, bro.
But I wouldn't mind seeing some of these movies didn't made, like especially the 1950s, 1960 Disney movies. Black Cauldron, I would love to see that.
Black Cauldron, they ain't going to do Black Cauldron. Come on, Gargoyle would be tight, too.
Gargoyle, yeah, I think they are planning on doing
Jordan Peele was trying to, I think they pushed that shit back to the
okay, Rescuers.
That shit was, those are dark shows. Those are nighttime dark shows.
Okay, Rescuers.
Rescuers be tight.
Aristocrats. Aristocats, I mean. Aristocats.
Aristocats be tight.
You just gotta change some things.
You gotta make some changes.
Fit with the time, you know. I ain't gonna say which.
Hey, that's the thing. Do you think Lion King also underperformed because Lion King was overhyped? Coming into it, because that Beyonce,
yeah,
Donald Glover.
I think that played a part, having all those stars.
Yeah, a lot of stars in that. Yeah, a lot of star power.
Whereas
James Earl Jones came back. You had, who did you play Rafiki? They had a star player Rafiki. You had Seth Rogen. It was star-studded cast, which is why I think that one. My man playing Scar.
I mean, Jungle Book technically had a star-studded cast too.
Yeah, Bill Murray. You had
Ben Kingsley. You had Idris Elba, Scarlett Johansson. What's his name? Damn it. He played King. Oh, he played King
Louis. Yeah. We talking about what's the guy? I know you're talking about though.
Yeah.
But even with that one, you want, even with Jungle Book though, like the singing, like I think Lion King based more. Think about Lion King's loving. We love Lion King because a lot of the music is great too. I guess it's great music. Yeah. Jungle Book only has the Baloo song. That's one we really care for.
But also, I think just Lion King, because they re-released Lion King so many damn times. Even when the anime, they re-released it like it was a little bit past 2010, but they were re-released in theaters and it had a pretty good number. Like it had a pretty good high box office for that weekend that they showed it. So people still were loving the animated one so much. So when you make the live action, I don't know. I just feel like people kind of. The fact that they saw the animated so many times in theaters, seeing the live action, didn't give them anything new.
I think the hype of Beyonce, and all, I think that just it didn't live to the hype that people had for it.
Yeah,
Because everyone always said Lion King, they didn't make Lion King live action. Everyone always said Lion King was the one. Mm-hmm. But this looks tight. This looks dope.
Yeah, this looks good. This looks good.
Disney building, when it comes to Disney making these...
I definitely agree with you as far as the song, but that definitely pulls you in.
Yeah, right when they play it. Yeah. Like, oh, damn.
But this was good, man. I'm excited to see it. Pinocchio, I'm not going to lie. I've also
damn, show Pinocchio ass for real.
Yeah. But I just the story, I've seen so many people put dark twists in the damn stories as far as like...
You finish that with Winnie the Pooh pretty soon.
Yeah.
Because they don't have the rights no more.
I'm Family Guy. I remember Family Guy did that Pinocchio skit. Hey, Pinocchio, did you reach into the cookie jar? He was like, yes. Are you sure? It's okay to lie. You know, because he was trying to trick him.
Sure.
And yeah, there's just so many. But this is good. This looks solid. I'm excited to see it.
And it's going to Disney Plus, so it's going to definitely get...
It's going to get higher.
I think that helps out. Like, Chippendale, I think, did so much better because it went to Disney Plus so people could just watch it right away. You know what I mean? I think we had to make the movie theater. Like, oh, I got to pay for
maybe
the
that's
ticket.
The, maybe
I don't know if I want to see it in theaters.
Maybe that's the new wave that it should be for live-action Disney remakes.
Depends on which ones.
Yeah.
This one, yes. A movie like... you do a live-action Gargoyles?
Oh, no, yeah.
That might go theaters and make that money, but... You guys, yeah, Disney Plus could just be the wave for live action movies for Disney. I mean, it could be the wave.
Yeah,
but Lion King made Jungle Book made money. They all made money.
Yeah, so I think
it wasn't like I'm making money. Just
yeah, you know. As far as the bots, as far as the critic reviews, but hey, they still don't keep milking it. So
for sure,
you know, I just if they're gonna do it, they should do it. Focus more on those older ones than the recent ones. That's just my opinion. But yeah, this looks solid. I will definitely check it out once it hits Disney Plus. Let us know your thoughts on Pinocchio, the live action trailer. What did you think about it?
Feel free. See Alice in Wonderland?
Huh?
Did we mention Alice in Wonderland?
What are you talking about?
I did live say, action.
Yeah, I said Alice.
Okay, I can make sure.
Yeah. yeah, and Cinderella actually.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. You missed.
Too. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, let us know your thoughts down below on the trailer if you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed this reaction, feel free to like, share, and subscribe. I'm DeAndre.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
I'm trying to end this video fast.
Anything your heart desires will come to you. I'm Javante.
I'm DeAndre, and this is Dre and Jay. Deuces.